Located in Ponte Vedra Beach, Florida, the Guana Talamato Matanzas National Estuarine Research Reserve is home to more than 73,000 protected acres of coastal land. The GTM Research Reserve is dedicated to the conservation of natural biodiversity and cultural resources through research, monitoring, and education. Florida is home to more than 300 bee species. At GTM NER, biologist Jamie Powellek researches the native bee population.
Just like there's bird watchers and butterfly watchers, I'm a bee watcher. So basically what I'm doing is doing an inventory of the entire research reserve. Before I can figure out what's going on with the bees here, I have to know what we have here. So that is the main goal of this last year and this year's project, is just to find out what kind of bees do we have living here. And then from there, I'd like to figure out if, by the ways that we manage some of the properties differently, does that have an effect on the species composition, or what kinds of bees that we find in certain areas.
A native species is one that occurs naturally with respect to a particular ecosystem rather than as a result of an accidental or deliberate introduction into that ecosystem by humans.
Native bees are extremely important not only to wild ecosystems but to agricultural ecosystems as well. They're important for pollinating most of our wildflowers. They are the number one pollinators in the world. They are built for pollination, so they are built to collect nectar and pollen and to feed to their young, but in doing so they actually fertilize plants, which helps them to set fruit and seed and then to repopulate themselves.
Nationwide, native bees pollinate crops worth an estimated $3 billion each year. In Florida alone, crops such as melons, citrus, beans, and strawberries depend on bees for pollination.
The biggest problem that native bees have is loss of habitat. So as urban areas expand, we are taking over areas that native bees would be nesting in. And most native bees are actually solitary. They don't have a queen or workers. It's just the work of one female building a nest, collecting nectar and pollen, and feeding, making food for the young that she lays in the nest. So when we spread out and we build huge cities, they're basically concrete jungles, so there's no areas left for bees to nest.
There are several ways to protect and encourage native bees to thrive. The most important way is to plant a garden that consists of native plants. Native plants are important because they have evolved with the native bee species within their environment and have created long-lasting and dependent relationships.
Encouraging people to plant native plants is sometimes can be a hard thing, but the benefits far outweigh the costs. There's less irrigation that has to go into having a native plant garden because they're adapted to the climate in your area. So once they get established, you really don't have to do much other than enjoy them.
Different native bees have different preferences in flowers. Some bees have long tongues, some have short tongues, some prefer pollen, some prefer nectar. To best benefit native bees, it's important to design your garden with a variety of plants that flower all year long.
So when you plan your garden, you go to the nursery, talk to people about some of the common native plants that they carry, when they flower, how to take care of them, and then design your garden in such a way that you have something flowering at all times a year, and plant them in big patches.
The relationships between native plants and native bees are crucial for the health of our local environment. Without these relationships, the bees and plants, as well as the animals and insects that depend on them, could suffer.
Bees are very susceptible, and if we lose them, then we might be losing some of these relationships that they have with the plants, because some plants are very specific, and maybe a very small number of bees or other animals pollinate them. And if we lose the bee, we might end up losing the plant. At least locally, things could go extinct.
For additional information, or to discuss these issues further, please visit the GTM Research Reserve website at gtmner.org.